Hello, welcome back to Blender Sushi Left Nodding. In this episode, I want to show you the latest new node from Animation Nodes. It's called the Decompose Text Node, so it's quite new. Just recently been added, and Omar actually responsible for it, and he made this a couple of example and documentations on the node. So I will actually just simply recreate this one. You can actually do this yourself, but I'm gonna explain from scratch. So let's get started. I have already updated to the latest animation nodes. So, and the node should be here, decompose text. And right away you can see B font is not supported. So you need to handle the font slightly differently. Normally when working with animation nodes, I turn off always. And it just enable these three, and yeah, let's get started. File, save as, animation node, an decompose text demo. And the font, if I actually try to load it, first of all, we gonna need to have a text object, and don't load the text font from here. Instead, we're gonna load it from here. So we need the font input, and for the font, I actually already grabbed something from Google Font. I like this Nova Mono. Just gonna select it here and then plug it here. Okay, so that's should be good, and we're gonna just type in hello world and decompose text, and this is gonna be the output. We're gonna actually use it as instance, so we need object instancer, and this guy need to be our text, and we also need text object output. Okay, and at the end we're gonna need to have matrix out. There is also object transform output. I don't know, but in this case we're gonna use object matrix output. So it's a lot easier and you can do more. So we have, this is the minimum nodes you need. So we have our font, we have our text. The font need to go to text object output as well, so we need to enable it. Enable font, turn on font, connect our font. So now we should plug in the transform into this guy. The instance, the length coming from this guy into the instance. Now we have the text instance being created. We probably want to enable this and this as well. The object goes in here and goes into the object matrix output, and the character goes into text. Enable this as well. So we're starting to get something. So we have our master text that we can hide. We have animation nodes objects that's generating this text. Hello world. Enable extrude if you want some kind of thickness, and enable bevel as well if you want. So bevel somewhere here, bevel depth, bevel resolution. So add some kind of bevel so it's nice and shiny. Okay, so our text is lying on the floor. Maybe you want to rotate it. You can do that using matrix math, multiply, compose matrix, and rotate this guy 90 degrees. So that's good. Now we want to actually animate the text character one by one, so it's pretty much like this. I'm gonna be using this same setup. So Omar is using offset matrix, that's Cool, let's actually do that as well. Offset matrices. Put it here. And we want to basically scale the text one by one after another. But here with the offset matrix, we set it to zero in the scaling. And all we need to use now is delay falloff. And we use the frame goes into the time, the falloff goes into here. Now we have our text that's simply scaling down. We want it to inverse the falloff, so it's scaling up. From nothing, scaling up. So yeah, so now we have these creations. It's around 100 frames. I want to show you how you can bake it and then export it as AR objects. So these animations looks fine, maybe more interesting if we, instead of using linear, we use the back or bounce or elastic. So this is always the smoothest one. You can also use elastic, bounce, or just use simple one back. Okay, now it's a matter of baking this. So I'm gonna save this and bake it out very, very quickly. Bake to keyframes. And then I'll set up I'm gonna select all these texts, select one, assign a material, maybe some kind of material like this, a little bit of metallic, roughness a little bit off, Control L, link the material, so everything gonna have the same materials, and then F3, convert the text into mesh. File, export, USD, selection only animation, export. So we should have our AR objects. So yeah, there we go. And this should work on iPhone or iPad, but if you want the for Android, file, export, GLB. Okay, so that's a include selected objects, geometry, apply modifier. So that's also should work as AR. So that's pretty much how you set this up. You don't always need to set it up from scratch. Of course, you can change the text. So I just made a change. I found this could be a bug actually. You see, the first one stay as H. This is a bug. I think I should report it to Omar. But if Omar, if you watch this, this is actually a bug. I test it out. So basically, the first one didn't go back to become a font. Remember how I converted into mesh at some point? So yeah, that's a bug. If I go back to the previous setup before I convert it into text, so this one works. But if I convert this into text object and I make changes, the first one stay as mesh. If I delete this and then expecting it to refresh, it doesn't do that. So, okay, if I reset it, it's actually fixing it. Okay, I guess it's okay then. Just a little bug. Okay, hopefully this is useful. You just actually save this. So next time you don't actually need to set up everything again and again. You just need to change the font, change your text, and you have the animations. Pretty cool. I'm just gonna write it down. Pretty cool. Still work. All right. Thanks again for tuning in. Let me know what you think, and I'll see you next time. Thank you. Bye.